Good morning. 36 degrees out there. Roads are wet. Rain should be clearing out by 9:30. 10 o'clock should be out of here. Heavier toward the Huntsville area right now. JC?
Yeah, she said yesterday, well, it ain't going to rain none tonight. I had to get some cushions in. I woke up this morning pouring down outside. Hey, good morning. I'm Jamie Cooper. This is Athens in the AM on a Tuesday morning edition of Cooper & Company Live. Thank y'all for getting up with us. This part of the show brought to you by Hometown Market 2. We'll be giving you those weekly specials coming up sometime tomorrow morning, right as soon as we get started. Zach's in the house this morning. He's over in his spot over there. Zach's corner of the world, the green light. Zach Green, Bama Zach at gmail.com. What's happening, Zach?
I don't know, Jamie. How you doing?
I'm good. Athens got beat.
Yeah, that was
upset.
That was not too well. Parker, anybody that knows Parker, they got one of the best teams. They've been good for years. So, and they beat Winona earlier this year too. Mm-hmm. Also, so.
Yeah, I heard that. We also got three teams right here still in. Plus, Zach was just telling me that Johnson and Spark Marion too. Falkville girls, got to give a shout out to them. We'll talk more about that in just a little bit too. And the Brewer girls and Tanner boys going for it today. Zach will update us on all that and how you can stay updated on that. Frank, Abby, and Brad in here this morning, getting this party started. We getting ready to head into spring. And how many days away from spring are we, Frank? How many days to spring?
I don't know.
20-something. I'll just guess at it. Frank's always alert, ready to go at 6 a.m. Don't forget we change time, too, in 2 weeks. So, also, woo! Glory, me and Maddie made our way down to the 26th annual Chili Day Challenge, down at Athens High School and the old gymnasium. We got an exclusive video of that coming up in just a little bit. Plus, we'll have a half-hour special on that that will start running this Friday and run through next week. But we'll give you the dates on that later once I figure out when we're going to run all that. And then we made our way over to Mark Moody at Marmac Real Estate. And he gave us kind of a tour of what was happening over at Ingalls Harbor at the Morgan County Home and Garden Show. The Home and Garden Show here in Athens starts this Friday, Saturday. Is it Saturday and Sunday? Not Friday, Saturday and Sunday. And Garth will be with us tomorrow and tell us all about that. It'll be over at the Limestone Event Center. So we'll talk more about that. It is a political season, too. Things starting to heat up. So we'll be talking to some politicians as we progress here. Well, let's get this party started on this rainy Tuesday morning. Weather going to be changing a little bit, but this weekend had shorts on, got out, blinded people in the neighborhood, walked around the circle.
Shh.
But it was a good one. Got to give a shout out to my buddy Johnny Lee Dees this morning. We're in Cross Point shirt, even though we're members down at Lindsay Lane now. So
still love Cross
Point. Thank all y'all folks for letting us in. Here's Gloria with a changing weather forecast.
Once they open the doors, they say stay, stay, stay. We'll talk about more of that in just a moment. But yes, 36 degrees out there. Burr, when you head out the door this morning, but things are going to warm up just a bit today. Saying 70% chance of rain. Much of that rain has already been here, starting to clear up here in Athens. Around 9:30, 10 o'clock. Heavier rain headed toward Huntsville right now. Should be out of here around 9:30, 10 o'clock. Then tonight, cooler temperatures move in. Actually, your high temperature tonight of 58. Then those temperatures start dropping. Tomorrow's high, only 36 with a low of 21. Might even see a few snow flurries out there. But don't let it worry you. It's not going to mess anything up. Just colder temperatures here for several days. Check out those lows. And then it looks like we're in store for a rainy weekend. We shall see.
Carry rainy weekend. Monday. I thought I saw the weekend was going to be almost 60 degrees.
It's going to be nice and warm, but we may see some rain on Sunday. Still too a little too early to tell. Bundle up, quick freeze, don't forget about that. It's going to be here yet again. And many of you that were out planting all of your garden, your plants, things like that, you may want to cover them up.
And the Chili Challenge, I got the winners in the News Courier this morning. It says here, Best Individual Award went to Mo Brooks.
Really?
Uh-huh. That's just sucking up to him, yeah. Best Group Award, the Athens Police Department. Best Booth Design was Jason Black. People's Choice Award was Consumer First Mortgage. Had a good time. Hey, the Entertainment, Frank, the Buzz Lovell Band, you ever heard of them?
Uh-huh.
They dedicated a song to you. I got them to change. I saw their lineup. It was going to be last. I got them to do it first. They dedicated it to you. Man of constant sorrow.
I love it.
So we'll have that coming up just a little bit too. But yeah, man of constant sorrow.
They did. They sang it pretty good too.
Huh?
They sang it pretty good too.
Yeah, plus I think we opened up with Entertainment. So we'll start it from the beginning and share a couple of minutes with you every day on that. Harold Wells should be with us, too. I think the city council met last night. Hey, Zach, what about NASCAR? I got rained out, so I was watching the old race. So I just forgot about it. Come to find out, they ran it, I think it ended to what, 10, 15, 10,
30? Yeah, it was about 10, 30. But what was so funny, Jamie, you had people getting on Twitter and Facebook congratulating Jimmy Johnson.
Yeah,
for winning.
Fox Sports, I mean, all these places, didn't they see the scroll at the bottom?
Well, this I thought it was the same. The race has started back.
No, it started.
How big a deal was that for Earnhardt to win?
It was huge. They were talking on the radio shows yesterday. They had never seen him that happy. You know, that was, you know, it's been 10 years since he won that race.
Goodness.
And plus, the number three was back out on the track.
Yeah.
So
where did he finish? Seventh.
He'd been in a couple wrecks, but he still finished up in the top 10. So, but for Dale Jr., there is a huge following. People love Dale Jr.
Hey, let me interrupt you a second here, but before I forget it, don't we have a happy birthday that Gloria needs to do this morning?
Happy birthday, Mr.
So we'll get to that.
We actually have a couple. First, you need to wish a happy birthday to your Aunt Polly.
Yeah, my Aunt Polly turned 80. We had a big birthday party, family reunion for her, and had a great time. So I think Brad's got a couple pictures of her and her birthday cake and my aunt and uncles.
And your aunt and uncles?
Yeah.
And there she is right there. And then
Aunt Polly.
The whole crew.
There's my daddy in the background.
If you've got a birthday you want to celebrate, get us some photos and we'll mention it right here on the program.
And that's all my mama and her brothers and sisters.
And a very special happy birthday this morning to Ray Gold.
Ray Gold.
Can't forget old Uncle Ray.
The man with the hair.
That's right.
Yeah, you and Ray Gold, y'all got the best looking hair.
Let's talk about the WWE getting their own network.
Really?
Yeah. Back. Started up yesterday.
And it pay-per-view only.
Well, no, I mean, you can watch it on your iPhone, iPad, your...
Now, is this 24/7?
24/7, you can go back and watch old wrestling.
It says here, every WWE, WCF pay-per-view event going back to 1983 will be shown on this network.
So you can watch anytime, and you can get the pay-per-views instead of paying $50 or $60 a month from your cable company. You're already locked in.
They've even got a reality show.
But
now,
they have
Sports Center style studio. You know that's fake, don't you?
Yeah,
no, it's
still
not real.
Entertainment, World Wrestling Entertainment.
Entertainment for those of you who ain't got nothing else to do.
Well, I guess I'm one of them, but the thing about it is...
I think we need to bring back Donkey Basketball.
It was a disaster yesterday. Everybody was trying to get on there, and it crashed. They were having...
There were that many fans trying to get on there?
Absolutely.
That's more exciting than racing, just going around in a circle. Boring.
Come on, Glory. Racing's fun, too.
Wrestling's a little bit more fun.
That's just because we ain't got no football to talk about. Are you telling me, Zach, that Clowney's going to be number one draft choice?
I mean, possibility. I mean, you run a guy his size, I mean, what is he, about 260, runs a 4.53. That's incredible.
Yeah. I mean, he outran Johnny Manziel.
Yeah. You know, I recorded the combine Sunday. AJ had a very good day. I mean, he only run a 4.91, but he's a pocket passer. He's not known for his speed. But he threw the ball very well. They said he probably moved himself up to at least a second round draft choice now.
All right. Let's go back and talk about the big news, though, that's going to come up. Here's Mulzon. Hold on 1 second. Give me a sec. You know, unfortunately, we Bama fans are going to see that play that defeated us forever. But. You know, Zach, I didn't think much of this, but is there a legitimate shot that this 10-second rule is going to pass?
I don't see it passing. As an Alabama fan,
how do you feel about this rule?
I think if the offense brings the guys, defense should have time to line up. But in my opinion, I think.